And I would like you to welcome back to the stage the one and only Miss Betty Drummond.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to start presenting the Dance Awards. But before I do, I have got a special award I want to present. And I'd like just to say at this moment, there are 58 dance nominations in this year's categories. And most definitely, you have to regard yourselves all as winners. True. The only way that you can become nominated for a Crystal Boot Award is because people vote for your dancers all year. And the reason we do that is so that we don't have a dance of the moment. So the dancers that are early in the year are not forgotten or overlooked by the dancers that are created more close to the Crystal Boot Awards. And there is one thing I also want to say about the voting structure, is that it all depends on two things. One is fairness, and one is accuracy. The fairness, ladies and gentlemen, is down to me, but the accuracy is down to you. We are all here tonight to celebrate dance, and we wouldn't be here without the people who vote. So this evening, on behalf of those 58 dancers that are nominated and their choreographers, I want to say thank you to you for your votes, for supporting this event, because without your votes, it just wouldn't happen. So thank you on behalf of all the choreographers. And when it comes to fairness, that is down to me. And I give each and every one of you the same opportunity to vote. So you can choose what dance you want to vote for. And I make no rules or no regulations about how old that dance would be. All I ask is that you vote for your favorite dance. So if that dance is old, I wouldn't deny you that vote. If that dance has been previously nominated, I do not deny you your vote. And if the dance has won before, if it's your favorite dance, you are entitled to vote for it. I hope you think that's fair. I certainly do. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to ask you to remember, please, to vote as often as you can in the charts so that we can always be accurate and fair with our nominations. Thank you. And I always say, when you get the opportunity to do something that hasn't been done, you must take it or live with the regret of not doing it. And tonight, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to give a Crystal Boot Award for the first time to a dance that you haven't voted for, to a dance that's quite old, but to a dance that has a magic and an enthusiasm about it. A dance that we love to see, and a dance that we would all love to be able to do. So with your help, Tim, on the count of three, I will say that this award is long overdue. It hasn't been nominated, but I think it deserves the award, and I hope you will agree with me. Three. 2, 1.
Something in the water. Some kids got on the train last night and started looking for a fight. No one had a word to say, just turned away. Hell, I feel ashamed today. It's gotta be something in the water.
Oh, wow. I'm in shock. I would just like to say I choreographed this in probably from my favorite. If anyone was around when the Kirby Suite started, I know a lot of you were, and especially Harrogate up in the Manhattan Club. And we did it. This Ethan, there was Scott Blevins, is one of my idols and my legends and what have you. And so back then, there were some really good, that was when New Line was New Line. They were doing some really advanced stuff. And in Kirby Suite, we were in a little locked room at the back. Everyone thought you had to have a password to get in. And it was a little room. Everyone used to come in. And when everyone else was doing beginner, we used to do advanced dances in there. And we were in there from 7 till 8, and everyone used to come down. They traveled down from Scotland. They traveled up from Birmingham and everything for 2 or 3 hours just to get to the Monday night club. And one night, Ethan Allen walked in, cheap seats, both of them, John, they both come in. And they give me the honor of just saying, this is our album, but we have one track on there, which is you have to do the most killer dance you can come up with. So you won't know it, but there was a dance called The Force, which was over 30 years old. There was Scott Blevins Out of Line. There was Dangerous. There was all sorts of little things around there. So I said, right, I'm going to come up and I'm going to throw them all together. So we're going to do it. And then there was the Running Man steps, where it was the normal one. So I said, right, we're going to do this streetwise thing and I'm going to shake it up a bit. And it came out as The Beast. And I would remember being on Geeta Renick. And she's a lovely woman from Harrogate. And I remember being in, and every Tuesday night I used to do the class, we went stopping at her house overnight. And I remember choreographing it on a rug. And Geeta, and I did Live, Laugh, Love on the rug as well. That sounded weird. Okay, I choreographed Live, Laugh, Love on that same rug, and she kept it, and she kept the rug for 20 years. She gave me into it last year. She's kept the rug. She had it on the wall, and it looks great, and it sounds a bit weird, and I'm going off the story. So I'll move it on, Betty. I know it was an add-in, but I would just like to say thank you to all the Kirby Suite and all of that lot and all the memories that was there. Oh, Tim as well. Tim, some of the stuff that we did with Tim, and I have some laughs as well. So this is a real gift to me, and I didn't ever expect that. So I thought it would well gone. Thank you very much.
You can hear it in the sand. Well done. Congratulations to Rob Fowler and The Beast. I myself actually went to the Kirby Suite and learned The Beast off you. And Adam's Ale. I went all the way there because in them days we didn't have the internet, did we? So we had to travel around to see our famous Rob Fowler.